Allah is my heart's speech. Your mercy is what I beseech. Keep in my heart your remembrance and in your deen allow me to advance. Help me in my quest. Permit me to pass the ultimate test. Help me in my quest. Permit me to pass the ultimate test.
We have another question from Omar Mahmoud. He says there is a hadith in Sahih Muslim reported by Ibn Mas'ud. He means Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with him. Shows the existence of jinn and evidence of how the Prophet ﷺ interacted. To what extent is it permissible for a human to interact normally with the believers among the jinn without seeing them or asking them for favors? Is this practice considered a shirk? Okay. In addition to the ahadith, there are several verses in the Quran, scattered all over the Quran, that talk about the jinn, which indicates that they are present. But there are two positions which are most concerned with the topic. In Surah Al-Ahqaf, in verse number 30, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells His most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how once when he was praying somewhere in the desert, a group of the jinn happened to hear his recitation, so they gathered and they accepted faith and they started delivering the message to their fellow jinns. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنْصِتُوا فَلَمَّا قُضِيَ وَلَّوْا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنْذِرِينَ Remember, as we drove towards you, a group of the jinn, نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقُرْآنَ They listened to your recitation of the Qur'an. فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنْصِتُوا When they attended it, they said, listen carefully, be attentive. This is something very unique. It must be the word of God. فَلَمَّا قُضِيَ So when you finish the recitation, which means they happen to be present so long as you are praying and reciting. When you finished, وَلَّوْ إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنْذِرِينَ They returned to their people of the jinn to warn them that Muhammad has been already sent and appointed. You have to accept faith. We notice that the Prophet ﷺ in this ayah did not even figure out there was other creations such as the jinn who were attending his prayer or listening to his recitation. The same has been confirmed in a whole chapter in the Quran, which was named after them, Al-Jinn, in the 29th part of the Quran. قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّهُ اسْتَمَعَ نَفَرٌ مِّنَ الْجِنِّ فَقَالُوا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا قُرْآنًا عَجَبًا يَهْدِي إِلَى الرُّشْدِ فَآمَنَّا بِهِ وَلَنْ نُشْرِكَ بِرَبِّنَا أَحَدًا So this ayah talks about the same incident. How did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam figure out that there was a group of the jinn who listened to his recitation, who accepted Iman and started giving da'wah to their fellow jinnis. قُلْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ Say, it has been revealed to me. So he was not in contact with them. They did not come to him to tell him. Every one of us has a qareen, a companion of the jinn. Even the Prophet ﷺ. Normally this companion, who is so attached to us, whispers to one to commit what's wrong and to do the evil acts, and he slows him down and hinders him or her from doing what's righteous. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, except for the fact that Allah has helped me out and my qareen has accepted faith. So he does not recommend to me anything but what's good. So we do not know whether there is a jinni right next to me right now or not. So how am I going to communicate with him? Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the jinn and the shayateen, إِنَّهُ يَرَاكُمْ هُوَ وَقَبِيلُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا تَرَوْنَهُمْ Indeed, him and his offspring or his host could see you while you could see them not. Which means they may be around us, so we're not required to seek their seeing or to communicate with them. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised us to recite certain adhkar upon entering our house or eating the food or embracing one's wife to keep the shayateen and the jinn away, because I don't know whether this jinn is a Muslim or a non-Muslim. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised us when we eat the meat to leave some left over on the bones or against the bones, because he said, indeed it is the food of your brothers of the jinn. So do not seek meeting the jinn or seeing them or communicating with them. We know for sure that the sorcerers, the magicians, and many fortune tellers and non-Muslim religious leaders, priests and rabbis, are in communication with the jinn in order to have access to things to convince people falsely that they are doing the right thing. I want to correct one thing in verse number 30 of Surah Al-Ahqaf with regards to فَلَمَّا قُضِيَ وَلَّوْا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنذِرِينَ. They returned to their people, warning. Barakallahu fikum. So my advice to you is, stick to the adhkar that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prescribed. Do not make any attempt or even contemplate the idea of communicating with the jinn, because you don't know whether it's he or she, Muslim or a non-Muslim. And this is another world. To us, is an entirely unseen. So do not dig into this area. You may get into trouble.